Welcome to Touch Technology Review. First of all, if you've just purchased your brand new iPhone and you've come to this tutorial, then congratulations for picking up your new phone. If you're a long-term iPhone user and you're just looking to update your skills, well, that's what I'm going to do today. I'm going to show you a very useful feature called Find My. It was recently updated in iOS 13. It was previously called Find My Phone, but now more appropriately named Find My because it does more than just find your phone. You can use it to find other devices that you register through the app, and also you can use it to find friends and family that you connect to the app. So a very useful application indeed for locating a lost device or locating friends and family in your network. So let's go ahead and check out how to use the Find My application. In order to use this feature, you have to set it up first. So to do that, tap on the settings icon on your iPhone, tap on passwords and accounts, tap on iCloud if you haven't done so already, enter your iCloud email address and password, then tap on the Find My icon just below. Tap on the toggle switch to the right to activate the Find My iPhone feature. When you do this, some options appear below. The first is to enable offline finding. Apparently, this allows your device to be found when not connected to a Wi-Fi network or a mobile connection. However, I don't know how this actually works. And if you stick around to the end of this video, I'll tell you about a situation where the Find My app actually failed me when my phone wasn't connected to a network. The next option is to send last location to the Find My app. It's a good idea to turn this one on too, as it will show you the last location of your phone if your batteries run out. Now tap on the Find My icon in blue on the top left-hand side of the screen to go back one level, and you should see the following. Find My iPhone should be set to on at the top. My location is set to this device. Share My Location is turned on. Below will be a list of your family members that have already been set up in the past. You'll be able to see the location of these family members by tapping on each one of them right here in the Settings app or by going to the Find My app, which we'll do so shortly. Because we set Share My Location to on, all family members can also view your location. This is great for most of us, but what if you want to keep your location private with certain family members and allow others to find you? Simply tap on their family member name and in the slide out panel, scroll down and tap on Stop Sharing. If you haven't set up a family sharing before, go back one step, tap on Family Sharing and add family members. When you add a member, you can invite them via an iMessage in person, or you can create a child account for children in your family without even having an iCloud account. The next thing I want to do is to show you how to share your location with people outside of your family group, so anyone in your contacts list. To do this, go to the Contacts app and tap on the person you want to start sharing your location with. Scroll down and tap on Start Sharing My Location. You can choose to share for 1 hour, share until the end of the day, or share indefinitely. If at any point you decide that this is an invasion of your privacy and you want to go incognito, tap on the Stop Sharing My Location in the contact entry for that person, and your location will no longer be visible in their Find My application. Now that we've done all that, let's take a look at the Find My app itself. You can find the application by locating the icon you see on screen right now, or swiping midway down your screen to reveal the search tool. Type in Find My and then tap on the app to open it. The app itself is really easy to navigate around. You'll see a large map that shows the geographic location or contacts in your contact list that you've set up to share with. You can zoom in and out as you would do with any map interface and tap on the profile picture to reveal some options for sharing on each person. If you're looking for a lost or stolen device, tap on the Devices tab at the bottom. All your devices will appear in this section. Again, you can use the map to zoom in and out to locate your device with precision. To alter your own profile, tap on the last submenu option on the bottom menu, which is called Me. In this tab, you can view your location at the top, turn the sharing of your location on and off at any time, and also decide whether you want to allow friends to see your location. This doesn't automatically share your location, but it does allow people to tap on your calendar entry on their phone and ask to share your location. You'll then get a request, usually sent by a message, and you can then decide whether you actually want to share your location or not. Similar to what I showed you in the earlier part of this tutorial. Going back to the People's tab, let's take a look at what else we can do. You can tap on anyone's profile icon on the map to access more information about them. You can get their name and location at the top, contact icon, and directions to get their current location, along with an estimated distance. And below is a notifications option. If you tap on add, you can now add a notification when they leave a location, and you can also use it to notify them when you leave or arrive at a specific location. So that's it. You now know how to use the Find My app to locate any Apple device you own or share your location and locate family and friends in your own personal network. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you found this tutorial useful. If you did, feel free to hit me up with a like and consider subscribing to the channel, and you'll be notified of up and coming VO releases. As a side note, I just wanted to mention that the Find My app will only work if your phone is connected to a network, be it a cellular 3G, 4G, or Wi-Fi connection. So if by chance the phone battery goes flat at any point, then you're not going to be able to find your phone in that instance or locate friends and family when the batteries are flat. Also, there's certain situations where it won't work, including when the phone is submerged in water. And I learned this the hard way myself when I lost the phone at the beach, and it actually became completely submerged in the shallows of the water at the beach. And when I went to use my wife's phone to go and locate the phone, it just didn't show up at all. So if it's submerged underwater, if the batteries are turned off, it's actually not going to work. But those are very few circumstances when it doesn't work. For most people, when you've just misplaced it or had it stolen, if you're quick enough, you'll be able to jump on and find your phone really easily using the Find My app. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one. Bye for now.